So we just got a tweet from Raven Software saying that we've got some more weapon balancing coming out today. This weapon balance has went live already, and in this video we're going to go through it all. We've also done a little bit of number calculating. We haven't done really much testing, but we just calculated the numbers to see what the TTKs would change to after all of these updates have taken place. If you enjoy weapon stat breakdowns and weapon comparisons, don't forget to subscribe to the channel as we try to reach our goal of 10,000 subscribers, and click that link in the description down below and subscribe to our second channel. We do post extra content over there as well. Like I said, these numbers that I'm going to give you are not from testing, it's just from taking the values that they've put in these patch notes and seeing what the differences would be. So the first thing they've done is made some bug fixes with the red doors, which I don't really care about, the battle pass and the PPSH. This is just the attachment's not showing up correctly when you're in the main menu, so that's not really too important. So they're quite happy with how the game is generally balanced. They said that the only outliers are the weapons that are going to be talked about throughout this patch notes. So the first one is the AS Val, which I didn't think needed actually touched with this because I don't think it is a popular gun in the first place, and this is going to make it less viable because this change in the maximum damage, changing it from 30 to 27, does actually change the TTK of this weapon. So it changes it from about 407 milliseconds if you're landing only chest shots to about 475 milliseconds. So that makes it along the lines of the OTS-9 at close range. So it's going to be very similar to that weapon without the Cold War movement, so it's not going to be as viable. It does have a slightly better damage range though, and damage drop-off points because it is an assault rifle. So it could still get used, but like I said, it will affect the weapon and people trying to use this gun surely for its TTK. So it's not going to be as viable as it was before. Then we've got the Fennec, and the Fennec has a bullet velocity increase, which I don't really think is going to help this gun in any way, shape, or form, to be completely honest. It is pretty weak in other departments as well, such as magazine capacity, which I feel like is what they probably should have looked at. But like I said, the Fennec's not really going to get touched with this. Another gun that did get a nerf was the Modern Warfare MP5. That is what Machine Gun Charlie is. Submachine Gun Charlie. So they changed the maximum damage from 34 to 31, they changed the damage range by 5.4%, and they gave it an upper torso multiplier from 1 to 1.1. Now, what they did here, to be completely honest with you, is they changed the maximum damage, but then they gave it an upper torso multiplier to bring it back to this damage value right here. So what this means is it's going to be less forgiving, because everywhere else you're landing shots is going to be 31 and not 34 like it was before. So if you landed a stomach shot, you actually got 34 damage as well with the MP5, and that is why it was such a good weapon, because it was quite forgiving as well. But now you still, if you land those chest shots, you'll still get that 526 millisecond TTK if you're landing only chest shots. But if you're landing shots anywhere else, well, other than the head of course, then you will get a slightly slower TTK. So that's what this is actually doing to the gun. So it's still gonna be viable, still a pretty good SMG. Is just changing the forgiveness of the weapon more or less, and I feel like that's the kind of recurring theme going on throughout this whole update. You've got the OTS-9, which has its ADS weapon sway decreased. Now that's not like the idle sway or anything like that, it's just because the iron sights on this gun have been broken since the gun's been launched. A lot of the animations on the OTS have been broken. When you're like tack sprinting, it makes it look really weird as well, so hopefully they fix that too. But basically it's just to make sure the iron sights work fine. That's all this is for, so you could track enemies a lot easier. If you've tried the OTS out and you see how it tracks, it literally like moves behind the back part of the gun, so it's really weird to track enemies, but they fixed that now. Then we've got the AMP, and this gun was overpowered. Like I said in other videos, we've literally made like many videos talking about how overpowered this gun is. And again, what they did here is they just basically change the forgiveness of the weapon. So you still get the same TTK, which is about 559 milliseconds, so that's pretty good, but only if you're landing all chest shots. Now, if you land shots anywhere else, you will get a slower TTK, making it less viable than SMGs, of course, because this is where SMGs are supposed to perform well. They also added a damage drop-off point here, so they've got 3 damage drop-offs now for the AMP. Before it only had 2, making it extremely viable. But now it has three, so it's got a mid damage drop off point where it does 28 damage, which is what it did before, but then they have this third damage drop off point as well now, which does 23 damage. The Akimbo M19s, I'm not really too sure what the TTK values were for before this update, but all I can imagine is that they've made it less consistent once again, or they've increased the TTK overall with this one because The TTK was one of the quickest in the game with the M19, so we'll need to do some testing on this one. I'm not really 100% too sure. Then with the Psykovs, again, they just changed the forgiveness of the weapon. So you still get the 551 millisecond TTK with the Psykov if you do land only chest shots. Landing shots everywhere else is going to make it less forgiving, of course, and it always had 3 damage drop-offs with the Psykov anyway, so that's not really changed much. You shouldn't really use this gun past 10 meters regardless, so everything past like this 24 damage shouldn't really matter too much to you, but again, it's just making the gun less forgiving. So if you enjoyed this video and you learned something new, don't forget to subscribe to the channel as we're trying to reach our goal of 10,000 subscribers, and click that link in the description down below and subscribe to our second channel. We do post extra content over there as well, and thank you very much for watching.